You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.
Good morning, boys and girls. That's right, I'm Alex Manners, and welcome to my live Solihull Radio Children's Show, where I will be with you right up until 10 a.m. And what a wonderful, wonderful show I've got for you today. I've got loads of wonderful songs to play for you, some excerpts from some old children's shows, some stories to read for you, and Rainbow Man is going on another fantastic, fantastic adventure. And today, Rainbow Man is visiting the wonderful Kenilworth Castle. Have any of you boys and girls been there? Well, it's a fantastic place, and you'll find out more about the things that you can enjoy at Kenilworth Castle with Rainbow Man and some of his best friends. So, if that all sounds really exciting, then please stay tuned right here on Solihull Radio from 8 a.m. right up until 10 a.m. this morning. If you have any birthdays that you would like me to read out, then don't forget you can email me in here in the studios on studio@solihullradio.com, or you can text in the studios on 075 64 30 30 64. And as always, I'll endeavour to read out your wonderful birthday messages. Well, the two children's shows I'm going to be playing for you today are excerpts from the Mr. Men Show and from NG Benji. So here we go with those two theme songs from the Mr. Men Show and NG Benji.
Mr. Men Show!
So, what do we do, Dan?
That's right, that was NG Benji and the Mr. Men Show, and if any of you remember those, then I'll be playing you some excerpts of those a little later on in my show. Also, later on in my show, one of my fellow presenters, Deb Stonley, will be reading a book called Room on the Broom, and I've had a listen to it, and I have to tell you that you should all stay tuned for that because it's a really, really fantastic book, and a new one for my Solihull Radio Children's Show. Yesterday, I went to watch Solihull Moors, and it was an absolutely fantastic match because they won 5-0. And I was really surprised when I went to bed in the evening and I was reading their programme because someone had written about my radio show in the programme. So, you never know, there may be a few Solihull Moors fans listening in to my Solihull Radio Children's Show, and hopefully they've got all their little boys and girls to listen in as well because they won't regret it because they'll have so much fun listening to all the wonderful songs and things that I've got for you this morning. Well, let's start the show with a song. And the song that I've chosen to start my show off today is a Disney song from the film Tarzan. And can anyone guess any songs from the Tarzan film? Well, the one I'm playing for you now is called You'll Be In My Heart. So please get jiving and grooving with this song, You'll Be In My Heart, from Disney's Tarzan.
Stop your crying, it will be alright. Just take my hand, hold it tight. I will protect you from all around you. I will be here, don't you cry. For one so small, you seem so strong.
they can't explain. Well, I know we're different, but deep inside us, we're not that different at all.
That was You'll Be In My Heart from Disney film Tarzan, and I hope that's got you all in the mood for the rest of my Solihull Radio Children's Show this Sunday morning. Later on, I will be heading to Tudor Grange Park for the Fun in the Park event that's happening from 11 a.m. So, if you tune in to Solihull Radio after my children's show a little bit later, then you will hear me and some of the other presenters at Fun in the Park, where we will be getting loads and loads of fantastic interviews and doing a little live show. So that is a little later on from 11 a.m. We'll be at Tudor Grange Park for Fun in the Park. Well, here is the first excerpt from one of those children's shows that I played you the theme songs of earlier. And the first show I'm going to play for you is The Mr. Men. And the excerpt from The Mr. Men Show today that I'm going to play for you is called Surprises. So here we go with The Mr. Men Show and Surprises. I hope you all really enjoy listening to The Mr. Men Show. And here we go with Surprises.
Mr. Men Show!
In Dillydale, there are many different kinds of surprises. There's the classic surprise party.
Surprise!
A surprise present left on a doorstep.
Surprise!
Or even an unexpected visitor from parts unknown.
Pain!
Of course, not all surprise visitors are from another planet, as Mr. Quiet is about to find out.
It is about time you answered the door.
Oh, Mr. Rude. Was I expecting you?
I am supposed to be on holiday at Mr. Small's Tiny Pines Cabins. But when I got there, I was told the cabins, they were all full. So, I thought, why not a packed suitcase go up the west? There must be some nincompoop in Dillydale I could surprise with a visit. And here I am. What is this for?
Oh, you know, good manners.
You expect me to eat nut loaf on my holiday? Lucky for you, I am hungry. Oh, this is boring. We need music.
I really dig that crazy meat. Yum! Is that nut loaf I smell?
Go away. We are trying to enjoy our meal.
What he said?
I can't resist a hot nut loaf.
Too bad for you. There is no more.
I don't suppose you have any beans?
Of course he has beans. Everyone has a tin of beans in their cupboard. If they don't, they are imbeciles.
All out of beans? How about pea soup? Then you can go.
Oh, go away. We are not interested.
Oh, Mr. Rude, 1,000 apologies for the mix-up at Tiny Pines Cabins. We have a cabin for you now.
Oh, thank you. Best news I've ever heard.
Oh, keep your tiny cabin, Mr. Small. I am happy where I am.
Ooh, are you going to eat the rest of that nut loaf?
Oh, forget it, Mr. Nuzzy. There is not enough food for anyone else.
Don't forget, there's some pea soup coming.
The soup!
Splendid! Sharing a meal with good company is always a delight.
I'll give you a delight.
Mr. Rude!
Oh, Mr. Rude!
Time to go!
We must get back to the Tiny Pines cabins. It's bingo night!
Can't miss that, little friend.
Finally, they are gone. Now we can enjoy our meal. What is for dessert?
Dillydale's newest restaurant is owned by Mr. Scatterbrain, who loves a good surprise.
Look at this menu! There's so much to choose from!
Surprise!
Whoa! You got us, Mr. Scatterbrain! No wonder it's called the Surprise Restaurant!
Let's get down to business. I'll have the soup.
Oh, I'm not the waiter. Bungo is. And he doesn't like it when I do his job.
Chimpanzee waiter! Another wonderful surprise!
Yes, really wonderful.
Oh, that's not all. Bungo?
A penguin in a bow tie? Surprise again!
Imagine that. Now, can someone in this zoo take our order?
Actually, no. They're still in training. But I'll be happy to take it.
But you said... Oh, never mind. I'll have the soup.
And I would like a bean burger, extra ketchup, if you please.
Coming right up, Bungo. Surprise! We brought you spaghetti and bean balls instead of a bean burger.
Why, that's amazing! I am suddenly in the mood for spaghetti and bean balls. I love this restaurant.
Well, that makes one of us. This isn't soup. It's warm pineapple juice.
Surprise!
Look here, Scatterbrain. Since when is pineapple juice a soup?
Here, have my wonderful spaghetti instead.
No thank you, Mr. Happy. I would like a bowl of soup, hot, with noodles.
Surprise!
Oh, soup on my head. Grrr. Oh, that's it. I'm leaving.
Oh, no, don't go, Mr. Grumpy.
Well, that's more like it. It's delicious. In fact, it's so good, I'd like to give my compliments to the chef.
Laredo! Mr. Crumpy wants to tell you something. Surprise again!
Crooked cucumbers, I hate surprises!
Planning a surprise party takes cooperation and hard work. And no one does that better than the Mr. Men and Little Misses.
All right, I'll keep Miss Sunshine away for at least an hour while you two decorate her house for her surprise party.
Oh, giving a surprise party is a very bad idea. Someone might faint and graze their knee.
It's a terrific idea. Now, whatever you do, don't ruin the surprise. Come on, Mr. Nabbit.
But Miss Scary, put me down. I'm very...
Hello, Miss Helpful.
Hello, Miss Sunshine. Care to go to the Dillydale Gardens with me?
Oh, I'd love to. Today's my birthday.
I had no idea.
Here are the decorations. Nice, safe crepe paper streamers and flowers.
No pointy pinwheels. No party masks. No fake spiders on strings.
What kind of horrible surprise party are you planning?
Where do you want the bats?
Right over there, Miss Whoops.
Miss Scary, I beg you to come to your senses. I was planning a rainbow and rabbit-themed party.
Talk about scary! Great idea, dividing up the room into two surprise parties. Hey, when Miss Sunshine comes, instead of surprise, let's yell boo, like this!
I didn't see that coming!
Miss Scary, that wasn't very nice. Now I have no one to help me put up my rainbow banner.
I'll help.
That rainbow better not touch my spiders.
It won't, but I think I can see one of your spiders dipping into my tutti frutti punch.
Where? Oh!
I can't quite reach.
Whoops! Batty-winged creatures of doom! Oh, very bad!
Hey! Catch my bats!
Boundless bouncing bunny is full!
Whoops, 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 whoops!
Mr. Nervous! Your cute little rainbows and bunnies are totally ruining everything!
I wonder if I should cover my eyes. Not that I'm about to walk into a surprise party or anything.
All right, there is a surprise party inside, but don't tell them I told you.
Happy birthday and goodbye!
Hideous, horrible surprise party!
Whoops, 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 whoops. Is the surprise that there is no surprise?
Surprise!
A party for me? I would never have guessed. Oh, and a bunny too. This is the best party ever.
So you see, surprises happen every day in Dillydale. Because everyone likes surprises. Well, almost everyone.
Aww.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.
Do you want to hear a joke about a pizza? Never mind, it's too cheesy.
Strike up the band, there is no work today. Hang out the flags, pack up your bags, it's a play day. Hooray! Strike up the band, strike up the band, for a play day away. Jump on the bus, it's here for us, there is no work. Here, there, everywhere, look over here. Dance if you dare. Come to the fair. Come on, let's have a show today. Step outside, give a smile for me, and shout hooray. Take a trip on a train.
Well, I hope you're having a wonderful time on my show, because I've got loads and loads more wonderful things coming up for you. Today, Rainbow Man is visiting Kenilworth Castle with his friends Giddy Gordon and Grumpy Doug. So here they go with Rainbow Man at Kenilworth Castle with his best friends. I hope you all enjoy it.
He is here, he is there, Rainbow Man is everywhere. Seek him here, seek him there, see him in his rainbow chair. Hello, Rainbow Man. Today, you will be visiting somewhere very old. Rainbow Man wonders where he could be going on his adventure today. Today, you are going to be visiting a local castle. Rainbow Man wonders if he will be able to dress up as a king or a knight. You may be able to dress up, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man smiles. Well, the castle that you will be visiting today is called Kenilworth Castle. Rainbow Man starts to cheer, woohoo! Do you know how old Kenilworth Castle is? Rainbow Man has a think, and then shakes his head. Well, Kenilworth Castle is over 800 years old. It was first built in the 1120s. Right, time for an adventure. Off we go. Rainbow Man zooms up in his chair and starts swirling around with lots of colourful swirls. Swirling here, swirling there. Rainbow Man goes everywhere. Rainbow Man appears outside the ticket office and shop. You have arrived at Kenilworth Castle, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man waves his arms in the air and starts cheering, woohoo! The castle used to be surrounded by a moat, so we have to cross this path to get to the main castle grounds. Even though there is no moat here today, the castle is still surrounded by a very large trench. Rainbow Man wonders what a moat is. A moat is a deep, wide ditch that surrounds a fort, castle, or town that is filled with water. A moat is a form of defence against enemies. Let's go and have a look at the castle. Rainbow Man walks along the path and over where the moat would have been until he reaches the castle grounds. He can see the castle over to his left. Look, there is the castle, Rainbow Man. But before we go and have a look at the castle, we will first go and have a look in the old stable. As Rainbow Man walks over to the stables, he spots a wall-like structure that he can see other people playing on. The wall is the remains of an old building. I have seen other children balancing on this and trying to walk from one end to the other without falling off. Why don't you see if you can walk all the way round without falling off? Rainbow Man climbs on the wall structure and begins to walk all the way round. He has a wobble at one point, but manages not to fall off. Well done, Rainbow Man. That looked like great fun. Let's go and have a look in the barn. In the barn, Rainbow Man spots some people eating cake and drinking coffee. He likes the look of the cake. That looks like the cafe, Rainbow Man. We could always come back and have a bite to eat later, if we have time. Rainbow Man licks his lips, as he likes the sound of that. Rainbow Man, what is that down the other end of the barn? I think it is an exhibition. Rainbow Man walks over to the exhibition. It's an exhibition about a castle and its people. Let's see how many interesting things we can find out about Kenilworth Castle. Rainbow Man walks around the exhibition, reading all of the boards and finding out lots of different facts. He finds one really interesting fact about the castle. In 1266, there was a 6-month siege on the castle. This was the longest siege in English medieval history. Henry III attacked the castle. The king erected stone throwing machines all around the castle, bombarding it with a continuous stream of missiles. The king eventually won, and Kenilworth Castle was restored to him. That is a great fact about the castle. Well done for finding that out, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man can see some dressing up clothes and goes over to see if he can dress up as a knight. He finds a knight costume and puts it on. You're a knight now, Rainbow Man. Sir Rainbow Man the Colourful. Rainbow Man enjoys dressing up as a knight. He begins to wave his sword around, pretending to have a sword fight. Then he begins to gallop around like he is riding a horse. Galloping here, galloping there, Rainbow Man gallops everywhere. Rainbow Man, still pretending to be a knight on a horse, takes off his costume and gallops straight out of the barn towards the main castle ruins and the part of the castle known as Leicester's Building. You are standing in the inner court now, Rainbow Man, by Leicester's Building. This part of the castle was built in 1571 specifically for Queen Elizabeth I. She used Leicester's Building when she visited Kenilworth Castle in 1572 and 1575. Rainbow Man walks closer to Leicester's Building and then starts waving. Who are you waving at, Rainbow Man? Rainbow Man is waving at Giddy Gordon, who is at the top of Leicester's Building. You're waving to Giddy Gordon, Rainbow Man. He is at the top of the castle. Giddy Gordon suddenly disappears. Where has Giddy Gordon gone, Rainbow Man? Rainbow Man shakes his head and starts to look for Giddy Gordon. There he is, Rainbow Man. He was coming down to say hello. Hello, Giddy Gordon. Rainbow Man tells Giddy Gordon about dressing up as a knight. Then Rainbow Man and Giddy Gordon decide to visit another part of the castle. They both pretend that they are knights on horses and gallop over to the Great Hall. You're funny, Rainbow Man, and you're even funnier, Giddy Gordon. As they both enter the Great Hall, they decide to climb right up the stairs to the top. From there, they can see the whole of the castle. I bet you both feel like kings of the castle. Rainbow Man and Giddy Gordon both nod their heads. You're looking right over the Great Hall now. It's very big. Giddy Gordon spots a big hole in the wall. That's not a hole, Giddy Gordon. That is the Great Hall fireplace. Rainbow Man and Giddy Gordon decide to visit another part of the castle. I wonder which part of the castle Rainbow Man and Giddy Gordon will visit next. They climb back down the stairs and walk away from the Great Hall, towards the keep. Once they reach the keep, they climb up another flight of stairs. You must be tired walking up all those stairs. Rainbow Man feels a little tired, but Giddy Gordon just starts jumping around, as he is not tired at all. Then Giddy Gordon spots a very thin window. That's a very small window, Giddy Gordon. Giddy Gordon wonders why the window is so small and narrow. Well, Giddy Gordon, the window is known as an arrow slit, and they were used to fire arrows through to attackers who may have been outside the castle. From the top of the keep, Rainbow Man can see the Elizabethan gardens below. He decides to go and visit the garden, but Giddy Gordon wants to stay in the keep. Okay, Giddy Gordon, you can stay in the keep, Well, goodbye. Rainbow Man waves to Giddy Gordon, and Giddy Gordon waves back. As Rainbow Man walks through the other side of the keep, he lands in the Elizabethan garden. He spots Grumpy Doug sitting on a step that leads down to the gardens. Hello, Grumpy Doug. What are you doing? Grumpy Doug tells Rainbow Man that he is enjoying looking at the flowers. Can Rainbow Man come and sit with you? Grumpy Doug nods his head, but says that he is not moving, and that Rainbow Man will have to sit on another step. Don't be grumpy, Grumpy Doug. Grumpy Doug does not think he is being grumpy. Did you know that this garden was lost for nearly 400 years? Rainbow Man did not know that fact, and nor did Grumpy Doug. Rainbow Man wonders what that big building is over the other side of the garden that looks like a greenhouse. That is an aviary, which is used to keep birds in. Well, that's all for today. It's now time to go. Colourful swirls appear, and Rainbow Man starts swirling around with them. Swirling here, swirling there. Rainbow Man goes everywhere. Rainbow Man appears back at home in his rainbow chair. Did you enjoy yourself today at Kenilworth Castle? Rainbow Man starts to cheer. Woohoo! What was your favourite part of the day? Rainbow Man enjoyed dressing up as a knight in the old barn the best. I wonder where you will go on your adventure next time, Rainbow Man. Rainbow Man shrugs his shoulders. Well, goodbye, Rainbow Man. See you next time.
That was Rainbow Man and his friends at Kenilworth Castle.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.
The two songs I'm going to play for you now are Justin Fletcher, Hands Up, and Disney's Forget About Love from The Return of Jafar. So here we go. I hope you get moving and grooving with these songs.
Hands up, you can hold your hands up high. How you doing? There's a party starting here. Won't you come and join the ride? 'Cause we wanna get together. Hey everybody, you'll be part of the gang. Gonna dance like crazy. So let's dance. Keep working, let us see those moves. Clap your hands. Stamp your feet. Come on! Hands up, you can hold your hands up. Put your hands up, come on, hold your hands up. Come on, hold your hands up high. Hands up, you can hold your hands up.
gotta put your hands up. See if you can reach for the sky. Hands up, you can hold your hands up. Gotta put your hands up. Come on, hold your hands up.
Forget about that guy. Forget about the way you fell into his eyes. Forget about his charms. Forget about the way he held you in his arms. Walking on air's obnoxious. The thrills, the chills will make you nauseous, and you'll never get enough. Just forget about love. Forget about romance. Forget about the way your heart begins to dance. Then you feel the blush when he's spouting out some sentimental mush. Love really is revolting. It's even worse than when you're molting. Enough of this fluff. Just forget about love.
I had almost forgotten the way it felt when he held out his hand for mine. My heart all aflutter.
Oh, how I shudder.
The first time we kissed,
it won't be missed. Forget about his touch.
I can't forget about his touch.
In the scheme of things, it doesn't matter much.
It matters so much.
You're better on your own. A meal becomes a banquet when you eat alone. Love's filled with compromises. And don't you hate those big surprises?
A cozy rendezvous.
Oh, please.
Candlelight for two.
Oh, jeez.
Look, you're calling my bluff. I can't
just forget about love.
Forget about my heart.
I can't forget about
how it felt to fall for you right from the start.
I'm still falling.
Whatever we may do,
whatever we may do,
you are here for me and I'll be there for you.
I'll be there to
wish, to want, to wander, to find the sun through rain and thunder.
Cozy rendezvous.
Yes, please.
Candlelight for two.
Jeez, enough is enough.
We can't forget about love.
A fabulous Disney song there that definitely got me moving and grooving, and I've got more Disney songs for you coming right up. Well, what's going on in our local area that we can go and visit over the next few weeks? Well, as I've mentioned before at the start of my show, today, after my Solihull Radio Children's Show, I'll be heading down to Tudor Grange Park for Fun in the Park, and that starts at 11 a.m. and there are lots and lots of things going on there. There are a dog show, a classic car show, there's live music, face painting, pony rides, games, and lots, lots more. And if you're down there, then please come and say hello to me, Alex Manners, and the rest of the Solihull Radio team. Then, at Hatton Adventure World on Sunday the 14th of October, or should I say, from Saturday the 8th of September until Sunday the 14th of October, there is a potato shindig. So, as part of your visit to Hatton Adventure World, you'll be able to help your children to learn where their food comes from by harvesting potatoes, and then you'll be able to take them home and cook something delicious with them. And that is potato shindig, on weekends from Saturday the 8th of September until Sunday the 14th of October. At Martineau Gardens in Edgbaston in Birmingham, there is a Stickman Trail, the lovable character from Julia Donaldson's popular children's book. On arrival, every child is given an activity sheet before heading out onto the trail. Throughout the walk, you're greeted by brightly coloured boards, each featuring pictures of characters from Julia Donaldson's story, plus memorable quotes too, like an excellent stick. Every board highlights something new to search for in the gardens, and kids will have the chance to make their own stick men when they visit. and that will be at Martin New Gardens until the end of December 2019. So you've got lots and lots of opportunities to head down to Martin New Gardens to go and have a join in on the Stickman Trail. Then at our chocolatey adventure down at Cadbury's World, you can jam along with Rasta Mouse and the Easy Crew from the 6th to the 7th and the 13th to the 14th of October. Rasta Mouse, Scratchy and Zuma head to Cadbury's World for the first time as the Easy Crew take to the Cadbury's World stage in their live entertainment show. So, if all those things at Tudor Grange Park, Hatton Adventure World, Martineau Gardens and Cadbury's World sound really, really exciting, then don't forget you can join in with all of those wonderful things. And if you want any more information on them, then don't forget to head to their websites. And here is another song, and this song is Justin Fletcher, 10 in the Bed. I hope you enjoy it.
It's 10 in the Bed. Get ready to do some counting with me. Here we go. There were 10 in a bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out.
Whoa!
Oh! Okay, there's only 9 left. Are you ready? There were 9 in a bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. Now, there's only 8. Here we go. There were 8 in a bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. How many left, everyone? That's right, 7. There were 7 in a bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out. Oh dear, there's only 6 left now. There were 6 in a bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out.
Yay!
Whoa, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 left. There were 5 in a bed and the little one said,
roll over, roll over.
So they all rolled over and one fell out.
Oh no!
Oh no, there goes another one. Only 4 now. There were 4 in a bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out.
Oh dear.
Wow, there's only 3 left in the bed. There were 3 in a bed and the little one said, roll over, roll over. So they all rolled over and one fell out.
Why?
There were 2 in a bed and the little one said,
roll over, roll over.
So they all rolled over and one fell out.
Oh. Ow.
Hang on a minute, there's only 1 left in the bed. There was 1 in a bed and the little one said, good night.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show. Hello boys and girls, are you all having fun? The time now is 8:45 and here is another excerpt from one of those children's shows, and this excerpt is from NG Benji and it's called The Big Sleep. So here we go with NG Benji and The Big Sleep.
So, what do we do, Dan?
NG Benji, NG Man, NG Benji, Jonathan.
Motorbike rider, he can make your engine go. He can make your engine go. There's all about teamwork.
Benji, Benji, Jollop and Dan.
What?
We're just getting the garage cleaned up for a visit from my cousin, Trucker Troy, and his friend, Big Rig. Great idea, Dan. Will you help us clean up?
Yes!
You will? Great! Now, where should I put this tyre? The hammer fits here. So where should the tyre go?
In the tyre shape!
All right! It goes there because it's the same shape as the tyre. Good work, team!
Hello! Hello, Angie Benji!
Hi, Al! Hello, Mo! I bet you're here for the welcome party!
That's right! Are Trucker Troy and Big Rig here yet?
Any minute now!
Farmer Fred sent some treats! Hey, yummy, yummy in my tummy!
What's that sound?
This is my newest invention, the video bone. We can use it to talk with Troy. It works just like a phone, but we can see him. Watch. There he is. Hello, Troy.
Howdy, Angie Benji. We've got ourselves one humdinger of a problem here. Hills, Big Rig, driving all day. Make it! Big hill up ahead! Help!
Oh, I'm not sure what the problem is. We'd better go and take a look. Let's go, team!
Hey, we'll set up the party! Hey!
Great! We'll be right back. What is it, Jollop? Do you hear them?
Come on, Big Rig! You can do it! Well... Little Wenji Benji, all grown up. Hey, seeing you makes me happier than a hamster.
Good to see you too, Troy.
Oh, sorry about that.
I got your video bone call. What's the problem, Troy?
Big Rig just can't make it up this hill, no matter how hard he tries.
There's a problem here without a doubt. Let's look around and check it out. Spin the screws. Hear the hum. Take the temperature.
What is it? Is he okay?
I know what the problem is, Troy. Big Rig is sleepy. In fact, I think he's so sleepy, he can't even make it up that hill.
You know, we have been driving all day. What do you think we should do, Angie?
Oh, Jollop thinks Big Rig should play catch, and Dan thinks Big Rig should take a nap. Maybe you can help, team. What should Big Rig do since he's tired? Play catch or take a nap? Take a nap! Good idea! Big Rig needs to get some rest. Then, when he wakes up, he'll be able to get over the hill.
All right. Big Rig, Cousin Angie Benji here says that it's time to slip the slope and go to sleep. Okay? Looks like Big Rig doesn't want to take a nap.
What can we do to help him fall asleep?
Huh? Hey, Big Rig's favourite blanket. That should help him sleep.
Good thinking, Jollop. He's still cranky. What do we do, Dan?
Hey, it's working. Ah, no! The video horn is ringing.
And he was almost asleep. It's my friends back at the garage. They all came over for your welcoming party.
Oh, that's as sweet as sugar.
Oh, hello! Hello, Angie Benji!
What's taking so long, Angie?
Big Rig's just tired. We're trying to get him to take a nap so he can make it back to the garage.
Well, hurry up because it's party time. We've even got music, listen. Party time, party time. Ooh, I love a party in the summertime. Party
hey,
time,
listen. Time. When Al started singing, Big Rig started to calm down. Maybe if we sing, Big Rig will fall asleep.
You mean like a lullaby?
Exactly.
Beep, 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 it's time to sleep. Beep, 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 it's time to sleep.
Is he fallen asleep?
Not yet. Jollop, put the blanket on him. Dan, you start rocking him. This time, we'll all sing together. Hey, maybe if you help us sing, Big Rig will fall asleep. Will you sing with us?
Yes!
Great! Ready?
Beep, 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 it's time to sleep. Beep, 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 it's time to sleep.
It worked! Big Rig is asleep. Nice singing. We couldn't have done it without you, team.
Hey, brilliant.
We'll be back soon. Doesn't look tired anymore.
He looks ready to rev. You want to take another try at that hill, good buddy? He made it! Yeah. That's my Big Rig.
Wow! Look at him go!
Hey! Let's hit the road. Don't want to miss my party.
Great! Follow us. Let's go, team!
Angie!
Hello, everyone. I'd like to introduce you all to my cousin, Trucker Troy.
Hi there, folks. Any friend of Angie's is a friend of mine.
And this is Big Rig, who happens to be very well rested.
Hey,
Big Rig,
welcome.
Hey. Nice to meet you.
Hey, everyone's here. Let's party.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah. Hey, come on. Dance with us.
Yeah.
Nice dancing, team.
It doesn't matter what colour your hair is, if your head's on back to front, or if your arm sometimes falls off. Not when you're hanging out with the Raggy Dolls. They're here next.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show. What do kittens like to eat? Mice cream. And that was NG Benji, and did you all enjoy it? Because I know I really, really enjoyed listening to it. Well, before I read you a story, here is our favourite song on the Solihull Radio Children's Show, and it's one of my favourite songs for sure, and it's Bob the Builder. And can you guess which Bob the Builder song it is? That's right, it's Mambo Number 5, and get mamboing and jiving with Mambo Number 5 right here on Solihull Radio.
Are you ready, Bob?
Yes.
What about you, Lumpy?
I'm a bit scared.
Okay, team, let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Everybody's outside, so come on, let's ride to the builder's yard around the corner. The gang's all here, and it's time for us to do what we wanna. There's a house with a roof that leaks. It's an urgent job, and it could take us weeks. There's Dizzy, Lofty, and Roly too. Wendy always knows just what to do. And there's no job too big or small. With scoop and mug, we can do it all. Metal, brick, or wood, it's all good, and we can always send in the tractor.
A little bit of timber and a saw. A little bit of fixing, that's for sure.
And if it looks like this, then you're doing it right.
A little bit of timber and a saw. A little bit of fixing, that's for sure. A little bit of digging up the roads. A little bit of moving heavy loads. A little bit of tiling on the roof. A little bit of making waterproof. A little bit of concrete mixed with sand. A little bit of Bob, the Builder Man.
Mambo number 6 and 7, 8.
A little bit of digging up the roads. A little bit of moving heavy loads. A little bit of tiling on the roof. A little bit of making waterproof. A little bit of concrete mixed with sand. A little bit of Bob, the Builder Man.
There's Roly, Lovely, Scoop, Mop and Izzy. So much work to keep us all busy. Can we fix it? Yes, we can. With the team and Bob, the Builder Man.
And don't forget, if you would like me to read out any birthday messages right here, live, on my Solihull Radio Children's Show, then you can email the studio in on studio@solihullradio.com. That's studio@solihullradio.com. Or you could text in the studio on 075 64 30 30 64. That's 075 64 30 30 64. And as always, I'll read out your birthday messages. But before we play some more songs for you, here is a story that I want to read for you. And the story I'm going to read for you is Walt Disney's Cinderella. So I really hope you enjoy this story of Walt Disney's Cinderella. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful girl named Cinderella. She was so kind that even the mice and the birds were her friends. Each morning, the birds woke her from sweet dreams with their song. Cinderella lived with her cruel stepmother and her two stepsisters, Anastasia and Drizella. They treated her like a servant. Cinderella had to do all the cooking and sewing and washing and scrubbing. Her stepsisters never did any work. One day, a royal messenger came to the house. He brought a letter from the king. The stepmother read the letter. The king was giving a royal ball for the prince that night. Every girl in the kingdom was invited. "That means I can go," Cinderella cried. Her stepsisters laughed. "Imagine Cinderella dancing with the prince," Drizella cackled. "She's only fit to dance with a broom," added Anastasia. "But the letter says every girl is invited," Cinderella insisted. "So it does," the stepmother agreed. "You may go if you can get all of your work done, and if you can find something to wear." "Oh, thank you," said Cinderella. She quickly ran up to her room. Cinderella pulled a dress out of her trunk. "This was my mother's dress," she told the mice. "Isn't it lovely? It just needs some decorations." Cinderella's mice had never seen her so happy. A thin mouse named Jack thought Cinderella would be the prettiest girl at the ball. A fat mouse named Gus agreed. Cinderella took out her sewing basket. "I'll need a sash and some beads," she said. Just then, her stepmother shouted, "Cinderella! Cinderella!" Cinderella hurried downstairs. "Cinderella, wash the floors," her stepmother ordered. "But I washed them yesterday," Cinderella said. "Well, wash them again," snapped the cruel woman. "And dust the drapes, and clean the windows, and finish the sewing." The mice felt sorry for Cinderella. "Cinderella, do this! Cinderella, do that!" Jack said. "Cinderella will never have time to fix her dress. Then her stepmother won't have to let her go to the ball." "Poor Cinderella," Gus agreed. One of the mice had an idea. "Why don't we fix the dress for Cinderella? We can do it." All the animals agreed to help. Gus and Jax sneaked into the stepsister's room. Drizella and Anastasia were getting ready for the ball. "This sash is old," Anastasia said. "These beads are horrible," Drizella said. They threw their things away. Gus and Jax took the sash and the beads. "Pretty, pretty," Gus exclaimed. "Shh," Jack hissed. He was afraid they would wake Lucifer the cat. But the mice made it safely back to the attic. Soon, every bead, beak and paw was busy. The animals measured and cut and sewed while they worked. Cinderella helped her stepsisters with their gowns. Soon, it was time to leave for the ball. "Why, Cinderella," her stepmother sneered. "You're not ready. What a shame." Cinderella slowly climbed the stairs to her room. "Oh well, what's a royal ball?" she said. "It would probably be dull and boring." And Cinderella sighed. Completely wonderful. But her dress wasn't finished. She couldn't go. Cinderella opened the door to her room. "Surprise!" shouted the mice and the birds. Cinderella thought she was dreaming. Her dress was beautiful. "Oh, thank you," Cinderella told her little friends. She put on the gown and hurried downstairs. "Isn't my dress lovely? May I go to the ball?" Cinderella asked. Anastasia and Drizella gasped. "Mother, she can't." "Well, we did have a bargain," began the stepmother. At this moment, the sisters recognized the things they'd thrown away. "My sash," Anastasia wailed. "My beads," Drizella shrieked. The sisters tore at Cinderella's gown. They took back the sash and the beads. Cinderella was left in rags. Then, Drizella and Anastasia went to the ball with their mother. Cinderella ran into the garden. She tried to remember her sweet dreams, but she didn't think they would ever come true. Her animal friends had never seen her so sad. "There's nothing left to believe in. Nothing," Cinderella sobbed. She didn't notice the lights that twinkled and danced all around her. But Jax and Gus did. They could hardly believe their eyes. The lights turned into a kind-looking woman. The woman patted Cinderella's head. She said, "You must believe in something, or I couldn't be here. And here I am. So dry your tears. Now, where did I put my wand?" The woman was Cinderella's fairy godmother. Everything she needed to help Cinderella was right in the garden. The fairy godmother waved her wand. Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo! Four mice became four white horses. Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo! A pumpkin turned into a beautiful coach. A horse became the coachman, and a dog became the footman. The fairy godmother was very pleased. "Hop in, my dear. We can't waste time," she urged. "Don't you think my dress," Cinderella began. "Good heavens, child, you can't go like that," said the fairy godmother. Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo! Suddenly, Cinderella was wearing the gown of her dreams. And on her feet, She wore glass slippers. The fairy godmother said, "Like all dreams, my magic must end. At midnight, the spell will be broken." Cinderella promised to be home before midnight. Off she rode to the ball. The ball had already begun. The king was not very happy. He wanted his son to marry. The prince had danced with all the girls at the ball, but he had not fallen in love with any of them. "Love at first sight only happens in fairy tales," the duke told the king. At that moment, Cinderella made her entrance. The prince stared in wonder. Here was the girl of his dreams. The prince asked Cinderella for a dance. Cinderella and the prince danced around the ballroom. Everyone wondered about the beautiful girl. "Do we know her?" Drizella asked. "The prince seemed to," Anastasia said jealously. "There is something familiar about her," the stepmother said. When the dance ended, Cinderella and the prince walked in the garden. They were falling in love. Suddenly, the clock began to strike midnight. "I must go," cried Cinderella. "Wait," called the prince. But Cinderella couldn't wait. As she fled, she lost one of her glass slippers. The prince showed the glass slipper to the duke. "Find the girl whose foot fits this slipper. I will marry her," the prince said. Meanwhile, Cinderella's dress had become rags again. The coach was now a pumpkin. The horses had become mice again, and the coachman and the footman had turned back into a horse and a dog. All Cinderella had left was one glass slipper. The duke searched the entire kingdom for the girl whose foot fit the slipper. Soon, everyone knew that the prince would marry that girl. When Cinderella heard this, she got a dreamy look in her eyes. The stepmother saw the dreamy look. She didn't want Cinderella to marry the prince. So, she locked Cinderella in her room. The stepmother put the key in her pocket and left. Gus and Jack saw everything. "We've got to get the key," Jack cried. Gus agreed. The two brave mice managed to get the key from the stepmother's pocket. They struggled to get the big, heavy key up all the stairs. Jack and Gus had to hurry. The Duke had just arrived. His footman carried the glass slipper. Anastasia tried on the slipper. Her foot was much too big. Drizella tried next. She couldn't even fit her toes into the slipper. "Are there any other ladies in the house?" asked the Duke. "There is no one else," the stepmother answered. The Duke was about to leave when Cinderella came down the stairs. Jack and Gus had freed her. "May I try on the slipper?" she asked. But the cruel stepmother tripped the footman. The footman fell, and the slipper broke. Luckily, Cinderella had the other glass slipper. Of course, it fit perfectly. Cinderella and the prince were soon married. It was Cinderella's dream come true. Jack and Gus weren't surprised, because they always knew that if you kept on believing, that's just when dreams come true. And that was Walt Disney's Cinderella. I really hope you all really, really, really enjoyed that story.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.
And this song is the Wombles, Remember You're a Womble. So please, remember you're a Womble and get dancing and jiving with this song.
Remember, remember. remember what a bumble, bumble, bumble you are.
And for all of you whose birthdays it is out there, have a happy birthday. And here is the Tweenies birthday song.
Thank you.
did you all enjoy that Tweenie song? Well, I love the Tweenies, and if any of you remember Bella, Milo, Fizz, Jake and Doodles as the Tweenies who used to be on CBeebies, then you'll all know what a fantastic, fantastic show it is and how much colour it is filled with, and you'll know why people like me love the Tweenies. Well, as I've been playing you some episodes of the Mr. Men show today, I thought I'd read you out some fun, fascinating and fantastic Mr. Men and Little Miss facts. But before I read you out the facts, I'm going to play for you the Mr. Men theme show song again. Here it is.
Mr. Men Show!
Well, if you want to see a picture of what some of the Mr. Men look like, then if you head down to the Solihull Radio Facebook or Twitter page, or my very own Alex Manners Facebook or Twitter page, then you can see some photos of the Mr. Men off the Mr. Men Show. Well, here are the Mr. Men and Little Miss facts. Fact number one is that the first Mr. Men book, Mr. Tickle, came out in 1971. And the original Mr. Men were Mr. Tickle, Mr. Bump, Mr. Happy, Mr. Nosy, Mr. Greedy, and Mr. Sneeze. Fun, fascinating fact number two. In 1981, the Little Miss series was born. The first Little Miss character was Little Miss Bossy. Fun, fascinating fact number three. Do any of you know how many Mr. Men books and Little Miss books there are? Well, I can tell you that there are 49 Mr. Men books and 42 Little Miss books. That means there are 49 Mr. Men characters and 42 Little Miss. Which is your favourite Mr. Men or Little Miss character? My favourite Mr. Men is Mr. Happy, because he's always so happy. Fun, fascinating fact number four. Some of the Mr. Men characters go by different names in the United States of America. For example, Mr. Jelly is known as Mr. Nervous, and Mr. Mean is known as Mr. Stingy. Fun, fascinating fact number five. Stella McCartney, the daughter of Paul McCartney of the group The Beatles, is the only person to have a Little Miss book written about her. Isn't that fascinating, fun, and very, very interesting? And for fun, fascinating fact number six is that Roger Hargreaves' favourite book is Mr. Silly, because of his silly behaviours. And the Little Miss Twins book were dedicated to Roger Hargreaves' daughters, Giles and Sophie. Isn't that fascinating as well? Well, those were the six fun, fantastic and fascinating facts about the Mr. Men and Little Miss. And don't forget that next week I'll have some more fun, fantastic and fascinating facts on something very, very different for you, and I can't wait to read them out. And here is a Disney song, Under the Sea, and I'll play this for you before I play you another excerpt of the Mr. Men Show. Here it is, Disney and Under the Sea.
Aria, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about gold. What more is you looking for? Under the sea,
under the sea,
under the sea,
under the sea.
Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore they work all day. Out in the sun they slave away. While we devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down here all the fish is happy. As up through the waves they roll.
The fish on the land ain't happy. They sat 'cause they're in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky. They're in for a worse of fate. One day when the boss gets hungry, guess who's gonna be under the
under
plate?
The sea.
Here is the Mr. Men Show, and this excerpt is called the Mr. Men Show Arts and Crafts. I really hope you enjoy it. Here we go.
Mr. Men Show!
The Mr. Men and Little Misses love expressing their creativity through arts and crafts. They enjoy making things out of clay, painting a portrait of a friend, or making a bracelet of colourful beads. The fun never ends when it comes to arts and crafts. Which is why Mr. Fussy has started Dillydale's first arts and crafts club. If only everyone took their crafts as seriously as he does.
Welcome to the first meeting of my arts and crafts club. Each week, we will work on our own craft. After we're finished, we'll show them off. Doesn't that sound like fun? Maybe.
Yeah, I guess so.
I'm sure you're all eager to see what I'm going to make. Fussy alla pasta, a sculpture of myself made entirely out of different pasta shapes.
I love pasta. Do we get to eat it after it's done?
Certainly not, Mr. Messy. You wouldn't eat a painting in a museum, would you? Besides, this pasta is not even cooked.
Too bad. I think I've got some spaghetti sauce in my pocket.
Best to keep the craft area clean and tidy, Mr. Messy. Moving on. Mr. Strong, what did you bring to work on today?
I thought I'd jazz up my bowling ball.
Ah, yes. The timeless art of covering a bowling ball with paint and glitter. I'm almost afraid to ask, what do you have in your craft bag?
I decided to make a mobile out of junk. Let's see. I've got a rusty fizzy drink can, a bell without a dinger, a couple of pizza crusts, and a dirty sock.
Oh, how creative. Well, let's get to work, shall we? Fussy a la pasta is taking glorious shape already.
I'm thinking pink glitter might make me a better bowler.
Go for it, Mr. Strong.
Pickles.
There's glitter on my rigatoni head.
Oh, sorry about that, Mr. Fussy. Maybe I'll just use these finger paints instead. Oh, sorry, Mr. Messy.
What are you sorry for? To be honest, I wasn't too sure about this whole craft thing. But it's really messy. How's about another squirt? Right here.
Okay. Ready. Aim.
That's what I'm talking about. Mr. Fussy, mind if I hang this up?
Go right ahead. The idea is to display our crafts when they're finished. I am only one little macaroni away from a complete sculpture of myself.
What do you think?
Well, it's important that we be free to express our creativity. Mr. Messy, I do not appreciate your junk raining down on me.
I'm almost finished too. Sort of. Wow, this glue's strong.
Uh-oh. Sweet apple strudel, my sculpture. Fussy a la pasta is ruined.
Wow, my mobile didn't even break.
Nothing but chance of shattered dreams.
Hey, Mr. Fussy. Maybe next time you should make a sculpture of yourself out of junk. It doesn't break so easily.
Who knew craft making could be such fun? In fact, I'd like you to have my bowling ball, Mr. Fussy, as thanks for holding this meeting.
Well, thank you, Mr. Strong.
Well, see you next week.
Huh? Next week?
Welcome to Miss Sunshine's Craft Corner. Let's give a warm crafter's welcome to your host, Miss Sunshine.
Thanks, Mr. Funny. We have a fantastic show for you today. My guest is very serious about arts and crafts. She loves to make costumes. She's also fond of bats, monsters, and fangs. How interesting! Please welcome Miss Scary! I had no idea you like crafts, Miss Scary.
Oh, yes. I've been doing them for years. I made that myself. Oh, what's this?
A foam flower. Today we're making flower-covered flip-flops.
That's really scary. I've got a better idea. I'll do the crafts and you can be my assistant.
Fantastic! Will you be needing any of these important craft items? Apron, goggles, oven glove.
No, no, and definitely no. Look what's in my craft bag.
Milk jug, ordinary string, cardboard tubes and buttons! I love buttons! Love them, love them, love them!
Oh, then you'll love what I'm making.
Try to guess. A button-covered birdhouse, flower pot, a cute holder for your remote control. Oh, a doll! I love dolls! Love them, love them!
It is not a doll! More like a monster!
I know I'm just the assistant today, but feathers and flowers always perk up a monster.
Look, a pretty rainbow!
What? Where? Oh, I missed it. I've never seen a rainbow inside before.
I'm finished! You think that's scary? Wait until you see the mummy I'm going to make from toilet paper!
Goodness, I think that's all we have time for today. Join us tomorrow for Miss Sunshine's Craft Corner!
Thank you.
over in Dillydale Park, there are some cows to be decorated.
Welcome to the second annual Dillydale Decorator Cow Contest!
As you know, artist, you will have 5 minutes to decorate your cow, which will be judged on originality and design by our judges, Mr. Noty and Mr. Small!
These cows are cheap!
Ready? Begin!
Greetings, Mr. Grumpy! A fine day to paint a cow!
I can't help but notice you're painting your cow plain old black and white.
That's what cows look like. You might as well just hand me the first prize now.
But isn't the idea to be creative when you paint your cow?
Go wild, Mr. Grumpy! How about green and orange stripes?
Do you mind? I'm making art here.
Miss Whoops, I've never seen anyone put silver studs on their cow before.
It's so easy. Yet so elegant.
Not to mention dazzling.
Ready to be milked, Bethy. May I call you Bethy?
I don't think she'd mind, Mr. Scatterbrain. Let's get started.
Oh, for noodle's sake, you're supposed to be painting your cow, not tickling it.
But how else are we supposed to get milk?
Might we be of some assistance?
Yes. Kick these two dodo birds out of this contest. They want to tickle their cow.
It's not against the rules to tickle your cow.
As long as you decorate it too.
Crooked cucumbers.
Yay! Bring the bucket, Mr. Scatterbrain.
You want to get that milk?
You got to tickle it out.
You want to get that milk?
You got to tickle it out.
1 minute, honest. Just 1 more minute.
You know, Mr. Scatterbrain, there's something strange about this cow. I don't think she's real.
Now that you think of it, she doesn't look much like Bartleby.
Don't you think you've gone a little bit overboard, Miss Whoops?
What can I say? I've got an artistic eye. Just one more stud. Whoops. That wasn't supposed to happen. Sorry.
My cow!
Time's up! Please stop all cow decorating! The judges have made their decision!
And a tough decision it was! But since Mr. Grumpy's cow is in ruins,
and Miss Whoopsie's cow is just one colour,
the winners are Mr. Scatterbrain and Mr. Tickle for their modern masterpiece of bovine brilliance!
Huzzah!
Yay! This calls for a tickle!
So the next time you do some arts and crafts, remember to have fun and put no limits on your creativity. Well, maybe some limits.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.
How do bees brush their hair? They use honeycombs. And here's a Frozen song, and it's called Frozen for the first time in forever.
It's Coronation Day!
The window is open, so's that door.
I didn't know they did that anymore. Who knew we owned 8,000 salad plates? For years I've roamed these empty halls. Why have a ballroom with no balls? Finally, they're opening up the gates. There'll be actual real life people. It'll be totally strange. Wow, am I so ready for this change? 'Cause for the first time, there'll be light. For the first time in forever, I'll be dancing through the night. Don't know if I'm elated or gassy, but I'm somewhere in that zone. 'Cause for the first time in forever, I can't wait to meet everyone. What if I meet the one? Tonight, imagine me gown and all, fetchingly draped against the wall, the picture of sophisticated grace. Ooh, I suddenly see him standing there, a beautiful stranger, tall and fair. I wanna stuff some chocolate in my face. But then we laugh and talk all evening, which is totally bizarre. Nothing like the life I've led so far. For the first time in forever, there'll be magic, there'll be fun. For the first time in forever, I could be noticed by someone. And I know it is totally crazy to dream I'd find romance, but for the first time in forever, at least I've got a chance. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, put on a show. Make one wrong move and everyone will know. But it's only for today.
It's only for today.
It's agony to wait.
It's agony to wait.
Tell the guards to open up the gate.
Don't let them
know it all ends tomorrow, so it has to be today. Cause for the first time in forever, for the first time in forever, nothing's in my way.
Have any of you boys and girls out there heard of the story, The Room on the Broom? Well, I've got a fantastic reading of the story now by my fellow presenter, Debs Donnelly, and she'll be reading Room on the Broom, that's written by Julia Donaldson. So here is Debs Donnelly reading Room on the Broom. I hope you all enjoy the story.
Room on the Broom. The witch had a cat and a very tall hat and long ginger hair that she wore in a plait. How the cat purred and how the witch grinned as they sat on the broomstick and flew through the wind. But how the witch wailed and how the cat spat when the wind blew so wildly it blew off the hat. Down, cried the witch, and they flew to the ground and they searched for the hat, but no hat could be found. Then out of the bushes on thundery paws there bounded a dog with a hat in his jaws. He dropped it politely, then eagerly said, as the witch pulled the hat firmly down on her head, I am a dog, as keen as can be. Is there room on the broom for a dog like me? Yes, cried the witch, and the dog clambered on. And the witch tapped the broomstick, and whoosh, they were gone. Over the fields and the forests they flew. The dog wagged his tail, and the stormy wind blew. And the witch laughed aloud and held on to her hat. But away blew the bow from her long ginger plait. Down, cried the witch, and they flew to the ground, and they searched for the bow, but no bow could be found. Then out from a tree with an ear-splitting shriek, there flapped a green bird with a bow in her beak. She dropped it politely and bent her head low, then said, as the witch tied her plait in a bow, I am a bird, as green as can be. Is there room on the broom for a bird like me? Yes, cried the witch, so the bird fluttered on, and the witch tapped the broomstick, and whoosh, they were gone. Over the reeds and the rivers they flew, the bird shrieked with glee, and the stormy wind blew. They shot through the sky to the back of beyond, and the witch clutched her bow, but let go of her wand. Down, cried the witch, and they flew to the ground, and they searched for the wand, but no wand could be found. Then all of a sudden, from out of the pond, leapt a dripping wet frog with a dripping wet wand. He dropped it politely and said with a croak, as the witch dried the wand on the fold of her cloak,
I am a frog as clean as can be. Is there room on the broom for a frog like me?
Yes, cried the witch. So the frog bounded on. And the witch tapped the broomstick and whoosh, they were gone. Over the moors and the mountains they flew. The frog jumped for joy and the broom snapped in two. Down fell the cat and the frog and the dog. Down they went tumbling into the bog. The witch's half broomstick flew into a cloud, and the witch heard a roar that was scary and loud.
I am a dragon as mean as can be, and I am planning to have witch and chips for my tea.
No, cried the witch, flying higher and higher. The dragon flew at her, breathing out fire. Help, cried the witch, flying down to the ground, since she looked all around, but no help could be found. The dragon drew nearer and, licking his lips, said, maybe this once I'll have witch without chips. But just as he planned to begin on his feast, from out of the ditch rose a horrible beast. It was tall, dark and stinky, and feathered and furred, and it had four frightful heads and had wings like a bird. And its terrible voice, when it started to speak, was a yowl and a growl and a croak and a shriek. And it dripped and it squelched as it rose from the ditch, and it said to the dragon, buzz off, that's my witch. The dragon drew back and he started to shake. I'm sorry, you spluttered and made a mistake. It's nice to have met you, but now I must fly. And he spread out his wings and was off through the sky. Then down the bird flew, and down jumped the frog, and down climbed the cat, and whew, said the dog. And thank you, oh thank you, the grateful witch cried. Without you, I'd be on the dragon's inside. Then she filled up her cauldron and said with a grin, find something, everyone, throw something in. So the frog found a lily, and the cat found a cone, and the bird found a twig, and the dog found a bone. They threw them all in, and the witch stirred them well, and as she was stirring, she muttered a spell. Iggity, ziggity, zaggity, zoom! Then out rose a truly magnificent broom. With seats for a witch and a cat and the dog, and a nest for the bird and a shower for the frog. Yes, cried the witch, and they all clambered on. And the witch tapped the broomstick, and whoosh, they were gone.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.
That was Room on the Broom, read by fellow radio presenter Debs Donnelly. And Debs has her own show on Saturdays from 6 till 8 p.m, and she presents the Cozy Kitchens Show. So if any of you are around on Saturdays, then have a listen to her fantastic, fantastic show. Here are a host of songs to play that I'm going to play for you now, and they're all songs of old children's shows. And see if any of you remember these songs from the old children's shows. And I hope all of you out there recognize some of these and get moving and grooving for the rest of my show this Sunday morning.
I'm PC Plum, and I tell you what I've done. I've pedaled round this island more than once or twice. And if you call on me, we can make a cup of tea. I'll tell you all about the bees and birds and mice. I'm PC Plum, and I'll tell you who I am. I'm your policeman, and I'll always be your chum. With my magnifying glass, I can look between the grass at all the tiny beasties. We look at them run. You can bet you'll see me a-coming. On my bike, I'm riding round the town. In the country, I check on all the wildlife. The people, trees and animals, I keep them safe and sound. Safe and sound. I'm PC Plum. PC Plum, I'm just a chicken. PC Plum, I love the country. PC Plum, be careful crossing. PC Plum,
I found a doggy, PC Plum. Here's your handbag, PC Plum.
Every girl, every boy, come on, open up your eyes. There's a world right here, full of wonder and surprise.
Let's go and find the thimbles!
Thimbles, thimbles, thimbles.
The sea is dark and deep.
But someone I know is safe and snug, and they're drifting off to sleep. Round and round, a little boat no bigger than your hand, out on the ocean, far away from land. Take the little sail down, light the little light. This is the way to the garden in the night. in the night garden.
Did any of you recognise any of those children's theme songs from old children's shows? Well, I remembered a lot of them, and there were shows that I used to watch when I was younger, and they were all fantastic, fantastic shows. Well, the time now is 9:53, and it's coming up to the last 7 or so minutes of my live Solihull Radio Children's Show this week. But never fear, I'll be right here next week from the same times, from 8 till 10 a.m. next Sunday morning. And hopefully the weather will be slightly better than the weather we've currently got today. And if any of you would like to read a story on my show, just like Debs Donnelly did earlier on, where she read Room on the Broom, then you can record yourself reading a story and then email it in to me right here at Solihull Radio. And you can email it in to us on studio@solihullradio.com. That's emailing in the recording of yourself reading one of your favourite children's stories to studio@solihullradio.com. Or alternatively, you could send me the story direct to my Facebook page, The Alex Manners. So if you go onto Facebook and find Alex Manners on Facebook, then you can send me the story direct. And I can't wait to see what your favourite story is and what story you've decided to read for me to play on one of my children's shows. Also, if you have any birthdays that you would like me to read out, then again, you can email me here at Solihull Radio on studio@solihullradio.com. Or, if you prefer, you could text in the studios. And the number to text in the studios is 075 64 30 30 64. That's 075 64 30 30 64. Well, the time now is 9:55, and to finish off my show today for you, I thought I'd play you an episode, or a song, should I say, and this song is Baby Shark, and I hope you all know and get moving and grooving for this Baby Shark song, and it gets you ready for the rest of your Sunday today and the rest of your weekend. Here is Baby Shark.
Baby shark, do 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 do. Baby shark, do 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 do. Baby shark, do 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 do. Baby shark.
Mommy shark, do 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 do. Mommy shark, do 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 do. Mommy shark, do 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 do. Mommy shark.
Daddy shark, do 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 do. Daddy shark, do 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 do. Daddy shark, do 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 do. Daddy shark.
Grandma shark, do 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 do. Grandma shark, do 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 do. Grandma shark, do 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 do. Grandma shark.
Grandpa shark, do 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 do. Grandpa shark, do 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 do. Grandpa shark, do 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 do. Grandpa shark.
Let's go hunt, do 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 do. Let's go hunt, do 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 do. Let's go hunt, do 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 do. Let's go hunt.
Run away, do 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 do. Run away, do 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 do. Run away, do 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 do.
Run away,
yeah! Safe at last, do 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 do. Safe at last, do 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 do. Safe at last, do 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 do.
Safe at last.
You.
It's the end, do 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 do.
Did you all enjoy that? Well, let's play it again for you before we go.
Let's go hunt, do 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 do. Let's go hunt, do 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 do. Let's go hunt.
run away, do 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 do, run away, do 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 do, run away, do 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 do,
run away!
Safe at last, do 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 do, safe at last, do 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 do, safe at last, do 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 do,
safe at last.
You.
It's the end, do 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 do, it's the end, do 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 do, it's the end, do 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 do, it's the end.
Next week on my show, I'll be playing you more wonderful songs like that, as well as Rainbow Man will be going on another fantastic adventure, and next week, Rainbow Man will be visiting the Four Ashes Golf Centre over in Dorridge in Solihull. I'll have some more excerpts from some old children's shows to play for you, and I'll be reading you some more fantastic, fantastic, wonderful stories. Well, if you've had fun at Kenilworth Castle with Rainbow Man and his friends, you've enjoyed making things with the Mr. Men, wishing through the sky with the witch from the book Room on the Broom, then join me again at the same time next week, from next Sunday, from 8 to 10 a.m. and I'll have lots and lots more wonderful things for you. Well, it's goodbye from me, Alex Manners, and it's goodbye from Rainbow Man. Until next week, au revoir.
You're listening to Alex Manners on the Solihull Radio Children's Show.